flying on to Chicago?
I'm on the 10 o'clock American flight. The meeting's this afternoon.
Then?
Then an early morning flight to Nashville and home to the coast tomorrow evening.
Seems like you're busier than ever.
Well, your mother knows how to reach me if you need me.
Dad? I'm glad you could stop by.
I wish I had more time. Now, when did you say you were planning on coming home again?
Not until the end of the term.
Well, you know, I don't think I can wait that long.
Something special. People know it. American Airlines. Something special in the air.
This is CBS.
This is Wile E. Coyote. He's been trying to catch that guy for years. What makes him think he can now? Ah, the Donnelly Directory. It's not the same old yellow pages. It's maps, guides, and coupons. It's a complete colorful yellow pages that's better and easier to use. Won't he ever learn? Oh, no. Good thinking. The Donnelly Directory.
And you have to make a decision based on the pluses and minuses. That are best for you and your family, and I have no question but what this is the best for myself and my family at this point in time. And my family basically is my wife, Carolyn, because our two kids are grown now and gone. But that and the combination of a great challenge there.
And as far as a replacement for Ray Perkins, it appears that Alabama wants to keep it in the family. Now, as Pat O'Brien reported before the game, Jackie Sherrill was contacted by Alabama officials this morning. He told them he was not interested in taking the Alabama job. However, knowing the nature of the coaching business, you must still consider Sherrill a candidate for that post at Alabama until that job is filled. Now, another name that is being prominently mentioned is Howard Schnellenberger. He threw his own hat into the ring yesterday, said he was interested in the job. Alabama has come back and said they are interested in Schnellenberger. Of course, he won a national championship at Miami. He's the current Louisville coach. His connection with Alabama, he played for Bear Bryant at Kentucky, and he coached on the Bears staff at Alabama. A few other names that have been mentioned as candidates, Bobby Bowden, the highly successful coach at Florida State. He's a Birmingham, Alabama native. And Danny Ford, who played for the Bear at Alabama, and who also has a national championship on his resume at Clemson. You know, it's amazing to think here we are on the first day of the new year, and two of the most prestigious coaching jobs in college football are open, USC and Alabama. Right now, let's change gears and take a look at one of the most prestigious bands in all of college football. It's the Ohio State Marching Band, some 230 members strong. They call themselves To Biddle, the best damn band in the land.
Distinction and charm. We conclude our salute to Broadway with a song that has become an inspirational part of our daily lives. Rodgers and Hammerstein's Climb Every Mountain.
Jacob's going to be playing with a cast on his hand. My ribs feel pretty good. I practiced yesterday. We expect Gary to be ready. I think everybody's going to be ready to go. It's like a do-or-die situation.
The offensive lineman, you know, we depend so much on our hands, on the pass pro and everything. So, you know, maybe it's going to hinder me, maybe not. It's something I'm going to have to work out, and hopefully I can work it out by Saturday, and it won't hinder me as much as I think it will.
Sometimes you can go in and play an extremely hard physical game and come out of the game clean. Unfortunately, this past week we didn't. This is normal for the course. You have good weeks and bad weeks. Unfortunately, last week it was kind of bad.
And now it appears things aren't getting any better for Washington because several players reported to Redskin Park this week fighting the flu. For CBS Sports, I'm Irv Cross.
And again, it all gets underway Saturday at 3:30 Eastern Time, Washington and Chicago, 3:30 Eastern Time for the NFL Today. It's 7-6 here at the Cotton Bowl, Ohio State in front of Texas A&M. And when we come back, we'll take a look at the unforgettable faces and moments in college football this season.
Pete Rose just got tough.
Because now I use Tegrin. Tegrin medicated shampoo. No more pretty shampoos for me. Tegrin's tougher than Head & Shoulders. It's got a special ingredient that's tough on everyday dandruff. Tough on all four major causes of flaking and itching. Tegrin's four times tough. It's the heavy hitter against dandruff for me.
And your wife.
So get tough on your dandruff with Tegrin lotion or now in brand new concentrated gel.
Listen to the heartbeat of America. Listen to the heartbeat of America.
Feel it in a 350 V8 Chevy with the most available power of any half-ton pickup. Nothing works like a Chevy truck.
The heartbeat of America. That's today's Chevy truck.
Imagine the power of two great computer companies coming together as one. Resources not just doubled, but raised to the power of two. Introducing Unisys. True competition in the computer industry, and a single winner will emerge. You.
As if students didn't have enough pressure already. And now there's a question of drugs. Someone pushing you to turn on or get high? Well, the answer is plain and simple in my book. No way. No way I'm messing up my life with drugs. And no way I'm letting someone push me down that dead-end street. Drugs can kill. We've seen that. Hey, I'm having too much fun to take that kind of risk. How about you? Don't let drugs get you down. After all, you can't be a hit when you're high.
Something to think about from the NCAA.
We're kicking off the new year here at the Cotton Bowl, and at the moment it's Ohio State by a point over Texas A&M. You know, college football 1986 will be remembered for many reasons. The climb to glory for Vinny Testaverde and his family, as well as his Hurricane team. Lou Holtz taking over at Notre Dame, going 5-6, but putting the fight back into the Irish. At Oklahoma, the outrageous and outspoken Brian Bosworth, both on the field and off. But above all else, what really makes college football so special is the intensity and emotion. Right now, let's recapture some of the moments that typify college football 1986.
If I knew back then all the things I know today, maybe I would not have changed one hour.
Baby, baby, it's our time.
Just some of the memories that will last from the college football season 1986. Well, we're making new memories here as we kick off 1987. We're at the Cotton Bowl. It's halftime, and Ohio State's in front of Texas A&M 7-6. Coming up, we'll rejoin Vern, Era, and Pat for the second half.
We thought early on that the Ohio State defense might be the key, and I think thus far that's proven out.
Yes, they must continue to do the same thing that they did in the first half. The secondary particularly has done a great job, the linebackers. But offensively, they have 215 yards, which is very impressive against this Texas Aggie team, but only 49 yards of those rushing. I think they have to establish the rushing game in the second half.
Pat, it struck me that Kevin Murray is not having a terrific football game thus far.
He is off rhythm, and it's because the Ohio State secondary has disrupted his rhythm. We said coming into the game, the key was the tight end Bernstein and Woodside, the halfback. Between them, they've only caught four balls. Now, if the defense is taking away your primary receivers, I think A&M has to go to their wideouts a little bit more with the pass. And will Roger Vick come back in the second half, the big fullback?
Here come the Aggies. They won here a year ago against Auburn. They are trying to become only the second team in Southwest Conference history to win back-to-back Cotton Bowls. And we'll see if they can accomplish that. But in the meantime, let's pause for this.
All right, Vern, when we last saw Roger Vick, he was on the sidelines nursing a right sprained ankle. I just spoke to Jackie Sherrill. He said Roger Vick should play in the second half. Let's go back upstairs.
There is Roger Vick.
Boy, that makes a big difference because Vick is such an important part of their inside running game. Again, he's 220 pounds. They need him. Again, we have a close ball game here, and A&M just can't get impatient.
A&M will return the opening kickoff in the second half. Pat O'Morrow getting ready to kick off for Ohio State. Mickey Washington, Rod Harris, and Ira Valentine of the deep men. 7-6, there is Rod Harris out of Dallas Carter High School. Starting wide receiver, though.